Game over.
Hello, fellow pilots, I'm Andrew Payne, and this is Reward Aircraft after 10 years playing with bots, which I called MB.5. Welcome in another episode of How to Play. Today, Martin Baker MB5, Tier 7 light fighter, which you can find in British Tech Tree on World of Warplanes website. History of this plane is very interesting. First flight took place in 23rd of May 1944. However, development of this plane was taking a long time, and MB5 literally couldn't do anything that existing planes wasn't been able to do in war. And it's important to mention that the first jet fighter was already being tested, flew first, before even MB5 get into the air. So, making long story short, that's why this plane never go into the serial production. It's only been one prototype. Despite the very good opinion of the test pilots like Captain Eric Brown or another Polish pilot, Janusz Żurakowski, acknowledged as one of the best acrobatic pilots in UK, he considered the aircraft to be excellent and better in many ways than Spitfire. Now, in a game we have a plane which is on paper very fast, very maneuverable and with decent firepower. But that's on paper. In reality, none of this is completely true. Let's start with the firepower. We have four 20mm cannons Hispano MK2W. These cannons are available to us, for example, on Tier 6 Premium Mustang in British Tech Tree. They are mounted in the wings and optimum distance is only 680 meters. And we just can't call this as a good firepower compared to other light fighters. Let me explain why. The problem with cannons being mounted in the wings. So here's the test me and my friend are doing in training room, dogfight 1v1. I'm going with BF-109G, and as you know, BF-109G have 30mm cannon and two heavy machine guns, and they have like shorter range of fire, and on the scale it's only 16 points in firepower, and MB5 have 21 points on scale. So here is what's happening, and you see BF-109G should have no chance on paper at least, yeah, because he have less firepower, but in practice he can take out the MB5 in head-on attack, because cannons in the wings cannot hit the airframe so easy as cannons and machine guns mounted in the nose section of the plane, specifically when we perform roll when we go in head-on with enemy. And of course this is only test, because BF-109G is a high altitude fighter and can attack from high altitude with extra energy, has advantage to decide when he wants to engage into fight, and so on and so on. So it's just a test to show you that even plane which is technically have less firepower still can win in head-on attack, specifically when I perform roll in this plane, so I make it harder for MB5 to hit me. So yeah, another thing I want to say here is Martin Baker have very poor resistance to fire. As you probably see on this example, he catch up the fire very easy. Almost every time when we have engagement, he catch up fire, and we can move now to aircraft survivability. So we have 300 HP points, which is pretty standard, but resistant damage is poor and resistant to fire is one of the worst. Like Japanese light fighters, you shouldn't go into any battle without the fire extinguisher. It's just simply must-have consumable. You're going to catch up fire a couple times in the battle, that's for sure. Now let's move to the airspeed. Airspeed on paper, 740 km/h, that's brilliant, excellent speed. But as I said, reality is a bit different, so here we go, a test. I have Spitfire, which have no consumable whatsoever or any equipment for speed. Just plain Spitfire. And MB5, however, is not specialized as well, but have equipment for speed on him, fully built for speed. And so, why MB5 cannot escape from Spitfire? Sometimes you manage to escape, another time you don't, and you're always gonna struggle with this. And the reason for that is simple. MB5 is almost twice heavier than Spitfire. Our game doesn't provide us with some of the details, like I mentioned in one of my previous video about another website where we can have more interesting information, including the weight of the plane. So here you go, you can see weight of the MB5 and weight of the Spitfire. There's a big difference, yeah? So MB5 have a good engine, but it's heavy as hell, like after a year in America. you know, what can help? Well, for this test, we didn't use important consumable called extra engine cooling. It gives you extra 10 seconds of boost, which is like must have consumable for this plane. With this, I'm pretty sure you should be able to escape from more maneuverable light fighters if you, of course, keep your right altitude. Because the top speed is much better, and with this extra boost, we should be able to reach this top speed. And for example, maximum speed of Spitfire is 670 km per hour, yeah? So it's much less than 740 of the MB5. And of course, that 740, that's gonna increase when you put equipment for speed, yeah? So top speed can be increased much more, and you should be able to reach this speed with this consumable. And as you know, most of the Spitfire pilots will build this plane for maneuverability, so they're not gonna build the Spitfires for speed, and you should be able to escape from Spitfire. Now, to sum up, if we want to outrun more maneuverable light fighter, we need to have this extra engine cooling. If we go into the fight with enemy without the consumable, or when it's on a cooldown, then we take huge risk of being outmaneuvered and not being able to disengage. Since we talk about how to escape from more maneuverable light fighter, we move now into the maneuverability of MB5. Making long story short, this plane has extremely good maneuverability. It's 8.6 average turn time without any consumables or pilot, which is great. It's exactly the same as Spitfire. So some of you may think, why we even escape from Spitfire when we have the same maneuverability? On paper, don't forget that. So the reality is a bit different. So basically, when we look into details, we can find out that this maneuverability is at certain speed, and this is the key. So basically, this plane is, because this plane is so fast, he has also very high minimum optimum speed. And because of that, he's doing his turn without any bonuses, of course, and pilot in 8.6 seconds, but in a range of this minimum optimum and maximum optimum speed, yeah?
Kurwa, choinki mnie załatwiły.
That's my best friend, Crusader. One big thank you for him for helping me on training room to test this plane. So, Spitfire have much lower minimum optimum speed, and because of that, he's doing his circle smaller. He's literally can stay. He literally can stay inside our circle. If we slow down more, then we are not in our optimum minimum speed, and our turn time is increasing. I explained that very well in one of my training video about maneuvers. So if someone is interested more into the maneuverability, dogfights and that kind of stuff, then I recommend you watching the training video first. So you see on the background now, I'm turning my Spitfire with the same plane, like the same plane, the same consumables, like, no, not consumable, there is no consumables or equipment for turning. We make it them absolutely even, the same, and you can see that I'm closing eventually on MB5 and I take him out. And this is all because we have better minimum optimum speed on Spitfire. So technically they have the same turn time, but Spitfire is doing smaller circle. Smaller circle, and because of that he can close in on MB5 and take him out. So a dogfight with Spitfire is not something what we are going to look for. Even if we build our plane completely for maneuverability, if we do full maneuverability build on MB5, we're still not going to be able to win the dogfight with Spitfire. If, of course, the Spitfire pilot is as good as we, because it's all about pilots also, yeah? So it's very important, you know, to know all the tricks and everything. But how to turn, maximize your turn rate, yeah? So for that, I have also this training video about keyboard settings, control settings for the game. So if someone watched that, he can increase his turn time also by setting up the controls in the right way. So that kind of things. But if we take two equal planes, then Spitfire should win dogfight, yeah? So Spitfire shouldn't go head on because have a little bit less firepower as well in the wings, but he should avoid the head on attack and go into turn fight. And we, however, in MB5, we should attack the Spitfire and then try to disengage, use our speed, disengage and come back for another attack. That's the way we should deal with Spitfires. Obviously, I'm sure that you're gonna meet in battles some Spitfire players who will lose the engagement because they just have lack of experience. Maybe they don't have the specializations at high level, or they don't have the calibration of the equipment, not fully built for maneuverability, that kind of stuff. But in general, if you take the equal two planes, Spitfire should win. So keep that in mind. Now we can move to the altitude performance, and unfortunately there is nothing to be proud of, like 1400 meters, that's the maximum optimum altitude. Everything above is going to affect your maneuverability and speed. So basically it's low altitude fighter, and this is like huge limitation for this plane, but that's the way it is. Keep that in mind that all the time that you go after high altitude fighters, you may expose yourself basically. It's very risky. You need to stay low and wait until they come down to you for a fight, not other way around. You see on the background example how dramatically my speed is reduced on 2000 meters, and the same will be with your rate of turn. It's increasing extremely on high altitude. It's not the same maneuverability. Keep that in mind. Now, equipment and consumables, what I recommend. In equipment, for first slot, we increase the accuracy. Kind of standard, we put a sight for it, and that's a very standard thing. On second slot, it's more important to have light frame and polished skin after specialization, or other way around, but those two are important. On engine, must have boost injection system. Very important, increase your top speed and acceleration. And then for consumables, on first slot we need fire extinguisher, no matter what, I mentioned that already, I guess. Second slot, emergency control system. It's very important because we pretty often getting critical damage, wings or tail, which doesn't allow us to escape or chase someone. Another slot is engine cooling. I mentioned that already. This is absolutely must have, very useful. And last one, whatever you like, this is for ammunition. I put my universal ammunition, but if you are rich, you can put gold ammo, whatever. Now, you may ask why I choose this setup to increase speed for this plane, not maneuverability, like some other YouTuber. So he put everything for maneuverability. Full maneuverability build, yeah. So I think this is wrong, absolutely bad idea. The answer for it, why, is simple. Other light fighter, which are more maneuverable, they're still going to be more maneuverable because they're going to build themselves also for maneuverability. So that's make no difference for us if we build this plane for maneuverability. That's not going to outmaneuver anyone. So better way is to have speed and decide when we are going to engage those fighters. And we use our firepower and surprise attack. It's better than get into a turn fight where we can't outturn the enemy and we just don't. On top of that, extra speed make our life easier when we are dealing with all the other light fighters which have better speed, better firepower. We can catch up with them much easier and take them out, yeah. And if they make mistake and go into turn fight with us, then we're still more maneuverable. Planes like E-220 or all German fighters, American light fighters, all these, and then heavy fighters, that kind of stuff. So now let's go through the planes which are more maneuverable, what we should do, and we memorize that so it's going to be easier for us in the dogfights in a game. And first one is of course Spitfire, tier 7. I mentioned that already during the video, those Spitfires eventually are more maneuverable. So what we should do, attack them, disengage and come back. Now, Japanese light fighter, we have two, and they both are more maneuverable, and obviously the pilots of those planes will build them for maneuverability, so our build for maneuverability not gonna help here at all. So what we can do is just decide when we're gonna attack them, because we have those speed superiority, so we can attack them, then disengage and come back. Yak 3RD, this is very maneuverable, very difficult plane to fight. You have huge advantage over MB5. we should go head on, try to use our armament in head on attack. If need RAM, this is the best option because Yak 3RD have better maneuverability and better speed. Theoretically, of course, it depends how the enemy gonna build his plane. But definitely don't go into turn fight and don't try to escape. So try to go head on. This is most difficult opponent for us, and just keep that in mind. But not many of them flying around, so I wouldn't be that much worried. And he have only one cannon, so that's why I suggest to go head on and kill him in head on attack. And even if he go behind us, then it's gonna take him like half an hour to take us out. Now we can move to Yak 3T. So this fighter have better firepower, so we're not going head on. And if we build ourselves full for speed, and most likely Yak 3T will be built for maneuverability, then he's going to be more maneuverable. So what we're going to do, we actually go into the turn fight with the Yak 3T, but on 1400 meters on our optimum altitude. Because Yak 3T have even lower optimum altitude, which is 1100 meters. So if we keep him around 1400 meters, then he's gonna lose his maneuverability significantly, because he's not gonna be that maneuverable at wrong altitude. So that's the way to do it, like go into turn fight, but on the right altitude. And then we move to another plane, LA-7. So that's the plane where we shouldn't go head on, because he have his armament in a nose section, 3 20mm cannons, so he's a serious opponent. It's less maneuverable significantly, so I would rather go into turn fight than specifically when this plane is not specialized. That definitely, if it's specialized, that could be risky. You have to take into consideration that those planes have very good rate of roll, so don't get into this rolling scissors kind of thing. So you have to be careful. This is a tricky one. Yeah, so I prefer to go like with Spitfire, so I surprise attack, and if he's turning after me, I disengage and then come back, surprise him again. Another one is LA-9RD. So this plane have very weak armament, only 2 23mm cannons in the nose section, so we definitely can go head on, ram if need, you know, try to get as much damage as possible in head-on attack. But it's a tricky one. It's very fast plane, so never try to disengage from this one, because he's gonna catch up with you. It's very fast plane, and if you have this build for maneuverability and speed as I have, more for speed, but you still should be able to out turn this plane in a dogfight. Just be careful with rolling scissors again, because very good rate of roll. So yeah, specifically if it's not specialized, then 100% you're gonna out turn this plane, so get straight in turn fight. But you should be fine even with specialized one, because those planes should be built as well for some kind of speed as well, so the many players will improve the speed, not only maneuverability on them. So yeah, it's always a tricky one, but first thing first, try to go head on. And the last one, we have Yak-3. So this is very simple. Yak-3 is very maneuverable fighter, so we always try to... This head-on attack is tricky as well, because he doesn't have that much less firepower than we have, so it's a tricky stuff. But if you can, surprise him and then disengage. Try to not to go head-on, and but it's better than... Everything is better than going to turn fight. Even if you build yourself into the turn fighter, the Yak-3 will out turn you. So this build for maneuverability not gonna help you with Yak-3. You actually make your position worse, because if you build for maneuverability, then you lack of the speed to escape from this Yak-3. You know, that kind of stuff. So never go into turn with Yak-3. For now, of course, lots of players don't know much about this plane, so we are gonna see a lot of success with the planes which don't know how to act against this MB5. So they're gonna go into turn fight when they shouldn't, that kind of stuff. Yeah, like in this example here, JL go into turn fight with tier 7, which is extremely maneuverable. Now I would like to come back to the armament of this plane, like 4 20mm cannons, but I can't resist to say that they have I mean, I have feeling that those cannons actually work like heavy machine guns. They set up on fire every second plane I'm shooting at, yeah? So in here, I'm trying to escape from the couple enemies out of the sector, and then I'm gonna go into the dogfight. But I just don't want to have that dogfight in a sector. So now, Vampire is coming here, so I'm trying to avoid him straight up. I get fire, yeah? Typical, that's okay. Nothing unexpected, but then, again, another plane I'm firing at, he catch up fire straight away, yeah? Like I would firing from heavy machine guns. So this is basically a situation where I shouldn't be in. There's a couple enemies here, and I don't have my extra engine cooling system ready. It's on cooldown now. I don't even have my boost available because I used that. And they come in for me. I'm the only enemy here. So straight away I catch up fire, and I'm just basically dead man. Most certainly this light fighter, Japanese light fighter, is more maneuverable than me, so there's no chance to survive that. Another example how desperately we need emergency control system. Yeah? So I use that, and thanks to this I fix my wing, and you know, without that I wouldn't be able to chase this heavy fighter. So this is must have consumable, as I said earlier. And in terms of this cannons which set up on fire almost everything I'm shooting at, I don't know, is that my luck or just my feeling? But just if you have the same feeling, just leave me a comment in the comment section under this video, because I'm really curious. Obviously we don't have all the information, game doesn't provide us with full information, so we don't know parameters of this cannon, how big chances they have to set up enemy on fire, yeah? And small piece of advice I'm gonna give you here, that if you fire, try to keep the distance. Don't close into the target if you have, of course, option, because those cannons are most effective like at 500 meters more or less, yeah? If you, again, fire, see that? Anyway, just I'm saying that these cannons, when you're just right behind the enemy, then it's gonna be very difficult to take out that enemy, because most of those shells not gonna go into the target, yeah? So that's where I see that most effective those cannons are at the distance, yeah? 600, 500 meters, 400 meters, but not like 100 meters. This is like, you probably will see that during the battles, that air defense aircraft, which are very close, when you get very close to the air defense aircraft, you can't really take him out. That's going to take ages, and it's very annoying. But that's how those cannons work. Yeah, and this here is actually four chevron battle. Not very difficult to get that kind of battle, specifically if there's airfield in the middle and you can do a lot of kills in it. Now it's a five chevron battle, but it's gonna be hard to believe in it after you see my start. Yeah, oh, by the way, fire. I set him up on fire, but smart guy have fire extinguisher, and this tier 6 light fighter, by the way, is almost the same maneuverable as we are, but since he is specialized, we can presume that he's more maneuverable in here. And I'm without engine, so I'm not in my optimum speed for turning, and this is it. Best start I ever have, like for 5 chevron battle. So this is a simple lesson. Try and do more of this surprise attack. If enemy see you, then disengage and come back again. Don't risk turn fight if you don't have to, specifically with those more maneuverable fighter or very equal fighter. We're just coming to the end of this video, so let's sum up everything now. If you want to be an ace in MB5, you should deal with those tier 7 planes as I described during the video, but you also have to do your homework and check all the tier 6 and tier 8 aircraft, and you have to like figure out how to deal with them. Is this plane going to be popular? I really doubt that, because it's, in my opinion, extremely difficult to play in it effectively. Good players could do very good result, of course, yeah, but again, they wouldn't be playing the plane which fly up to 1400 meters effectively, like where there are many more light fighters which are more capable of doing much better results. But let me put it this way, the missions for this plane are not difficult. If we take for consideration that we have the event now which allowed us to do huge results, like for example the last mission is to have an ace, 20 kills in battle. Normally that would be quite difficult for most of the players, but because of the event, ace is much more achievable, let's say. I can't complain that this plane is not overpowered, because who wants another overpowered plane in this game? Like, you know. So this is good work by World of Warplanes team. I don't believe that I'm saying that, but like, it's look like pretty balanced. So, but you know, after 10 years, I would expect a little bit more, like tier 8, for example, or maybe even tier 9. Okay, so we still have a Christmas ahead, so I won't complain. We'll see. So officially, I will say Martin Baker MB5 is below the average, and it will very quickly disappear from battles. But it's nice to have it for free, premium plane, like for new players specifically. Yeah. All right, guys. I hope you like it, found it useful. So if you're thinking about buying certificates to finish off the missions, or you want to sacrifice your family day to grind in weekend, I hope I help you to make right decision. If you like it, please leave a like and subscribe for future content if you haven't already, of course, and have a great hunting. See you in next one. Take care, guys.